Good evening students. Today we are going to discuss about Biot-Savart's law, derivation for an straight infinite current carrying wire. In the previous class we discussed about Biot-Savart's law in vector form. So now with the help of that we are going to solve this. So let us consider an infinite straight current carrying wire. This is an infinite wire carrying a current I. In the current carrying wire, I am going to consider a small current element, IdL vector, already we know this. And this is the angle theta, that is the angle between the current element and this distance. Let us assume this distance from B to P will be BP is equal to R. Similarly, I am drawing a line from here perpendicular to this another line and marking this point as C. So now if I draw the line perpendicular to this line, the CP is also equal to and the bit AC, that bit AC is called your DR. This is totally, this is R, and I have extended the length and the angle slight increasing. So it will be R plus, the total length AP will be R plus DR. In that I can divide AC as DR and CP as R. So this two AC and AP and BP both are equal to R. And these two, that is this R is variable. Why it is variable? Because it is making an angle. I am considering a new angle called phi. And this, for the small current element, the small angle contributed for the current element will be d phi. So what happens to this phi? I said this is an infinite current carrying wire. If I increase the distance, I am increasing. That is, if the current carrying wire keeps on moving to infinite distance, the angle also keeps on increasing, to which is contributing for the entire magnetic field. So the angle increases till infinity, then the angle becomes at infinity, it will become 90 degree. Similarly, the downwards, this side, 0 to minus 90 degree. So the limit of this phi varies from, if the line overlaps with this O, the angle will be 0 degree. If it is moving towards infinity, plus 90. The downward infinity, it will be minus 90. So both the sides, the wire is infinite, not one side. So minus 90 to plus 90, that is, minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2 will be the limit for the angle phi. So next we are moving. So this is theta. And this distance OP is equal to this R. This R is not a variable, because for this distance only we are finding the magnetic field. And we are considering this is a center, because I can't able to plot center for an infinite wire. I am considering this as center, my center. And from the center where I am finding the magnetic field, that distance will not vary, because this is a constant thing I am keeping here. These things, angle making things, will vary. So with respect to the center, this side is infinity, this side will be infinity. So this distance will be a constant. So OP equal to R. And the other thing is theta, everything we have written. So now the magnetic field due to this small current element, already we have written in the Biot-Savart law, mu naught IdL sin theta divided by 4 pi that R square, this R square, because this is the current element and the field distance. And according to right hand thumb rule, the direction of current is upwards and field is moving in this direction, that is in this direction. So field here, right side will be inwards. So it will be a cross mark. So what next we are going to do? So here in this expression, we have too many variables. One is DL, the current element we can vary, and the sine angle theta. If I increase the angle, the theta angle keeps on reducing. So theta will vary. And this distance R also, if you increase the angle, the distance R will increase. Here it will be R. Here the distance will be large. So I can't able to use all the three variables at a time to solve this. So I am going to convert all the three variables into a single variable. So how to do that? So let us consider, you know this angle is phi. So cos phi of this, this is adjacent, this is hypotenuse. So it will be R by R. Cos phi is R by R, that we know that. And here we have a small triangle we have taken. This is a perpendicular. You take the triangle. This is A, enlarge it. This is B. And this is C. This is a perpendicular thing. And this line is moving like this. And this angle we have drawn as theta. And this angle will be theta plus d theta. But approximately we are writing it as theta. Because d theta is very small, no need to consider that. We can assume that also theta. So here, we know that this distance BC is your arc length. you studied in your lower class, 10th, arc length. Arc length means radius times the angle. This is the arc length means this is the radius and this is the angle. So radius is r, angle is d phi. So this is your arc length BC. So this is r d phi, and we know that AB is the element, current element. So only the length we require. So this is your dl, and this is will be, that is AC. This is r I already said, and the remaining part will be, I have already written dr. Here I have written, so AC is equal to dr. So all the things we got. In the expression we have sin theta. So find sin theta from this triangle. So from this, sin theta is equal to, this is opposite hypotenuse. So it will be r d phi by dl. That is sin theta. So now substitute that in dB. So dB is equal to nu naught idl sin theta. So I is there, dl sin theta. So we bring this dl here. Dl sin theta will be r d phi. So it will be r into d phi divided by, so 4 pi r square. That is the expression. Here we have the expression. So dl sin theta is r d phi. So r will be cancelled. And we know that here we have cos phi. This thing we have cos phi. From that, r equal to r by cos phi. So substitute that r. So mu naught I d phi by 4 pi r divided by cos phi, it moves to numerator. So this is my final expression. I know that this r is not a variable, I already said. That is a constant. Everything is constant. So we have only one variable term, that is called a phi alone. Theta itself is converted. Theta, dl and this r, everything is converted to angle phi into a single variable. So already I have informed you, this phi varying from 0 to plus pi by 2 and downwards 0 to minus pi by 2. That's all. So now substitute the limits and integrate the terms. So now substitute it. So dB on integrating, we will get b. Similarly, on integrating, the constant terms are mu naught I by 4 pi r. So, integral of cos phi d phi between the limits, minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. If it is an infinite wire, limits vary from minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. One side infinite, other side finite means limit will be 0 to pi by 2. Both the sides finite means we want to see the shape of the wire, hexagon shape, square shape, rectangle shape. From that, we want to decide the angle. From which angle to which angle. So here, on substituting this, mu naught I by 4 pi r, cos phi if you integrate, you will get sin phi, upper limit and lower limit will be plus minus pi by 2 minus pi, plus pi by 2. So mu naught I by 4 pi r, so sin pi by 2 will be 1, minus the lower limit is sin of minus pi by 2. You know that sin of minus theta is minus sin theta. Sin of minus theta is minus sin theta. So sin of minus pi by 2 will be minus sin pi by 2. So minus minus plus. So it will become mu naught I divided by 4 pi r. Sin pi by 2 is 1 plus 1. So it will be 2. Finally the answer will be mu naught I by 2 pi r. It is not 4 pi r. So for a straight current carrying it is 2. So 2 will be cancelled. So for an infinite straight current carrying wire, the magnetic field at a point, at a distance from the center of the wire will be mu naught I by 2 pi r. This only we are going to solve in Ampere's circuital law easily. In a direct method, Ampere's has given this formula. But in Biot-Savart law, we have derived so much things. But what is the purpose of Biot-Savart law? In Ampere's circuital law, that law can be used only for a infinite current carrying wire. It cannot be applicable for finite current carrying wire because it is a direct method. But here we are using some derivations and we have substituted the limits. With the help of this, we can do for plenty of types. That is called a finite wire, infinite wire, one side finite, other side infinite, and a rectangular wire, square wire, hexagon, any shape of wire we can do. So with the help of this idea. So in the upcoming classes, we are going to see the derivation of the other part, that is a finite wire and a square wire, everything. Thank you.